Welcome to our Mystery Sleep Stories channel, your sanctuary for meditation and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this quest for deep sleep. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our mystery bedtime stories. So, let the tale begin. The Hidden Treasure of King Tutankhamun. Chapter 1. The Call of the Ancients. Detective Adrian stood before the imposing structure of the Great Pyramid, its weathered stones whispering tales of an ancient civilization that had thrived along the banks of the Nile. The call of the ancients resonated through the air, beckoning him to embark on a quest that promised untold mysteries, the search for the hidden treasure of King Tutankhamun. Adrian's journey began in the heart of Cairo, where the bustling cityscape transitioned into the vast desert expanse that cradled the pyramids. The detective, armed with an insatiable curiosity and a determination characteristic of his investigative prowess, gazed upon the colossal monument with a mix of awe and anticipation. As he entered the pyramid's depths, the air changed, thick with the scent of antiquity. The passageways, dimly lit and adorned with hieroglyphs, seemed to tell a story only those attuned to the whispers of the past could comprehend. The detective's footsteps echoed in the confined space, creating a rhythm that resonated with the energy of the ancients. Adrian consulted ancient texts and deciphered cryptic maps that hinted at the burial chamber concealing Tutankhamun's fabled riches. Legends spoke of treasures entombed with the young pharaoh to accompany him in the afterlife. And the detective sensed that unlocking this enigma required more than just archaeological prowess. It demanded an intuitive connection with the spirit of ancient Egypt. Venturing deeper into the pyramid, Adrian encountered sealed chambers that had remained undisturbed for millennia. The walls, adorned with intricate carvings and paintings, depicted the life and reign of Tutankhamun. The detective's keen eye discerned the symbolism woven into each depiction, unraveling the narrative of a pharaoh whose legacy held more than met the eye. The air became charged with a palpable energy as Adrian approached a chamber marked by a distinctive seal. A rush of anticipation surged through him, and with careful precision, he opened the door to unveil a hidden passage leading further into the heart of the pyramid. The detective's heart raced as he delved into the unknown, guided by the call of the ancients echoing through the narrow corridors. As Adrian navigated through secret passages, the ancient architect's ingenuity became evident. Booby traps and intricate mechanisms designed to protect the pharaoh's resting place challenged the detective at every turn. Yet, undeterred, he pressed forward, deciphering the complex puzzles that guarded the path to Tutankhamun's hidden treasure. The detective's journey through the pyramid became a dance with the shadows of history, a choreography of discovery that unfolded with each step. The hieroglyphs on the walls began to illuminate his path, providing clues to the nature of the treasures awaiting discovery. Adrian, immersed in the convergence of past and present, felt a profound connection with the pharaoh who had long been entombed in the heart of the pyramid. As the detective moved closer to the fabled burial chamber, the weight of centuries seemed to press upon him. The call of the ancients reached its crescendo, urging him to unravel the final layers of mystery that shrouded Tutankhamun's hidden treasure. Adrian, standing at the threshold of the burial chamber, prepared to face the revelations that awaited. A journey that promised not only the discovery of material wealth, but a communion with the timeless echoes of a civilization that had left its mark on the annals of history. Chapter 2: Shadows of the Past. Detective Adrian pressed forward into the heart of the pyramid, the dimly lit corridors casting elongated shadows that danced upon the ancient walls. The intricate hieroglyphs narrated the life and times of Tutankhamun, weaving a tapestry of a pharaoh's journey through both the earthly and divine realms. The call of the ancients echoed louder, resonating within the detective's soul as he delved deeper into the shadows of the past. As Adrian traversed the labyrinthine passages, he encountered concealed chambers that held relics of the bygone era. Golden artifacts and jeweled amulets spoke of the pharaoh's opulence, while statues of deities stood as guardians of the treasures that lay beyond. The detective, with a discerning eye, examined each piece, unraveling the story of Tutankhamun's life and the wealth he sought to carry into the afterlife. The walls of the pyramid seemed to come alive, animated by the detective's exploration. Hieroglyphs depicted the young pharaoh's coronation, his connection to the gods, and the rituals performed to secure his place in the divine realm. Adrian, in a trance-like state, deciphered the symbolism and iconography, revealing not only Tutankhamun's earthly reign, but also the spiritual journey that transcended mortal boundaries. Secret chambers unveiled hidden alcoves containing artifacts of mystical significance. The detective marveled at the meticulous preservation of sacred relics, scarabs, ankh symbols, and statuettes representing the deities worshipped by the ancient Egyptians. Each discovery added a layer to the intricate narrative, linking Tutankhamun to the spiritual realms and the cosmic forces that guided his destiny. As Adrian approached a chamber adorned with murals depicting the pharaoh's journey to the afterlife, he sensed a convergence of the earthly and divine. Scenes of ritualistic ceremonies, guided by priests wearing ceremonial masks, unfolded before him. The detective's understanding deepened as he comprehended the significance of the rituals designed to secure Tutankhamun's passage into the realm of the gods. Further exploration led Adrian to the inner sanctum, a chamber adorned with symbols representing the duality of life and death. The detective, in awe of the spiritual significance embedded in the hieroglyphs, recognized the delicate balance that ancient Egyptians believed governed existence. Tutankhamun's tomb, designed with meticulous care, seemed to encapsulate the eternal struggle between mortality and the transcendence of the soul. The detective's journey through the shadows of the past brought him to a mural depicting the judgment of the deceased pharaoh in the afterlife. Anubis, the jackal-headed god, weighed Tutankhamun's heart against the feather of Maat, symbolizing cosmic order. Adrian, captivated by the symbolism, pondered the implications of the pharaoh's quest for a harmonious existence beyond the mortal realm. As the detective stood at the crossroads of history and myth, he understood that Tutankhamun's hidden treasure was not merely a collection of riches, but a testament to a civilization's intricate beliefs. The shadows of the past whispered secrets of a pharaoh who sought to transcend the boundaries of mortality. And Adrian, now entwined with the spiritual essence of Tutankhamun's journey, prepared to face the challenges that lay ahead in the heart of the pyramid. The call of the ancients resonated stronger, urging the detective to uncover the deeper layers of the pharaoh's enigmatic legacy. Chapter 3: The Labyrinth of Secrets. As Detective Adrian continued his odyssey through the depths of the pyramid, the labyrinth of secrets revealed itself with an intricate dance of shadows and light. The detective faced a myriad of concealed chambers and hidden corridors, each guarded by puzzles and enigmatic mechanisms designed to protect the sanctity of Tutankhamun's burial site. The call of the ancients echoed through the labyrinth, challenging Adrian's wit and determination. Navigating the cryptic passages, the detective encountered chambers adorned with celestial motifs. Star maps and representations of cosmic alignments adorned the walls, hinting at a deeper connection between the earthly and celestial realms. Adrian, immersed in the symbolic language of the ancients, deciphered the significance of the celestial markings, a key to understanding Tutankhamun's quest for transcendence. The labyrinthine journey led Adrian to a chamber bathed in an ethereal glow. In the center, an intricate mechanism awaited, its purpose concealed within the complex interplay of gears and symbols. The detective, relying on a fusion of intuition and analytical acumen, endeavored to unlock the puzzle that guarded the next stage of his quest. As the detective manipulated the ancient mechanism, a concealed passage opened before him, revealing a subterranean corridor adorned with murals depicting sacred rituals. The walls seemed to breathe with life, telling the tale of priests clad in ceremonial attire, and the offerings presented to appease the gods. Adrian, now fully immersed in the labyrinth of secrets, sensed that he was unraveling the layers of Tutankhamun's spiritual journey. Further exploration led the detective to a chamber where statues of Anubis, Horus, and other deities stood sentinel. Each statue, with its watchful gaze, guarded the treasures that lay within. Adrian, understanding the divine significance, paid homage to the gods before delving into the heart of the chamber. Within the sanctum, the detective discovered a series of alcoves, each containing artifacts of profound significance. Sacred amulets, adorned with protective symbols, spoke of Tutankhamun's desire for divine guidance. Adrian, with a respectful touch, recognized that these relics were not mere trinkets, but conduits to the spiritual realms that the pharaoh sought to navigate. The detective's footsteps echoed through the subterranean corridors as he neared the central chamber, a sacred space where the true essence of Tutankhamun's hidden treasure awaited. The walls, embellished with symbols representing the cosmic forces, seemed to resonate with an otherworldly energy. The call of the ancients intensified, urging Adrian forward into the heart of the labyrinth. As the detective entered the central chamber, he found himself in the presence of an altar adorned with symbols that mirrored those etched onto the artifact he carried. The convergence of the symbols created a symphony of energies, connecting the earthly realm with the divine. Adrian, holding the artifact against the altar, felt a surge of energy, a cosmic resonance that hinted at the profound revelations yet to come. The labyrinth of secrets, with its celestial markings and sacred chambers, had become a gateway to understanding Tutankhamun's pursuit of enlightenment. The detective, standing at the precipice of the central chamber, steeled himself for the challenges that lay ahead. The call of the ancients, now an echoing crescendo, promised not only the unveiling of Tutankhamun's spiritual legacy, but also a communion with forces that transcended the boundaries of mortal comprehension. Chapter 4, Unveiling the Legacy. Detective Adrian, standing at the threshold of the central chamber within the labyrinth of secrets, felt a palpable shift in the air, a convergence of energies that heralded the unveiling of Tutankhamun's profound legacy. The walls, adorned with celestial symbols, seemed to pulsate with anticipation as the detective approached the altar, the artifact in hand resonating with the cosmic forces at play. As Adrian carefully placed the artifact upon the altar, an ethereal glow enveloped the chamber. Symbols etched onto the artifact mirrored those on the walls, creating a harmonious dance of light that transcended the material realm. The detective, now at the epicenter of a cosmic resonance, sensed that the true revelations were about to unfold. The altar, bathed in the celestial glow, became a focal point for the energies that permeated the chamber. Adrian, with a mixture of reverence and curiosity, observed as the symbols on the walls seemed to come alive, weaving a narrative that transcended time. Scenes of Tutankhamun's life, his spiritual pursuits, and the cosmic forces that guided his journey unfolded before the detective's eyes. The air within the chamber seemed to vibrate with the echoes of ancient rituals. Adrian, attuned to the cosmic symphony, felt a connection to the spiritual essence of Tutankhamun, a pharaoh who sought not only earthly treasures, but also a transcendence of the mortal realm. The detective's senses heightened as he perceived the intertwining threads of the pharaoh's life and the divine forces that shaped his destiny. As the celestial glow intensified, a holographic projection materialized above the altar. Scenes of Tutankhamun's coronation, his interactions with priests, and the rituals performed to secure his passage into the afterlife played out in a spectral display. Adrian, now immersed in the cosmic narrative, understood that the hidden treasure was not confined to physical riches, but encapsulated the spiritual evolution of a pharaoh. The holographic projection then shifted to the judgment scene, a depiction of Tutankhamun standing before Osiris, the god of the afterlife. Anubis, with the scales of Mahat in hand, weighed the pharaoh's heart against the feather of cosmic order. The detective, captivated by the symbolic drama, sensed the gravity of this moment, a pivotal juncture in Tutankhamun's quest for transcendence. Adrian, now a witness to the divine judgment, understood that the hidden treasure was not a conventional hoard of wealth, but a legacy of spiritual enlightenment. The holographic display revealed Tutankhamun's heart, depicted as a delicate lotus, perfectly balanced against the feather of Maat. The cosmic forces, it seemed, acknowledged the pharaoh's pursuit of a harmonious existence. The central chamber resonated with an otherworldly melody as the holographic scenes transitioned to the pharaoh's journey through the celestial realms. Adrian, enraptured by the cosmic ballet, followed Tutankhamun's soul as it traversed the realms of gods and goddesses. The detective sensed that the true treasure was the spiritual ascension achieved by the pharaoh, an enlightenment that transcended the boundaries of earthly wealth. As the holographic display reached its zenith, a final scene unfolded, a depiction of Tutankhamun's soul merging with the cosmic energies, becoming a constellation that adorned the night sky. The detective, now enlightened by the cosmic revelations, stood in awe of the legacy unveiled within the labyrinth of secrets. The celestial glow gradually subsided, leaving the central chamber in a state of profound stillness. Adrian, holding the artifact in hand, felt a profound sense of connection to the pharaoh's journey and the cosmic forces that had guided it. The hidden treasure, he realized, was not only the culmination of physical riches, but a testament to the spiritual evolution of Tutankhamun's soul. As Detective Adrian emerged from the labyrinth of secrets, he carried with him not only the artifact, but also the intangible legacy of a pharaoh who had dared to seek enlightenment beyond the confines of mortality. The echoes of Tutankhamun's cosmic journey lingered in the air, whispering tales of a hidden treasure that transcended time. The detective, enriched by the cosmic revelations, stood on the threshold of a new understanding, an understanding that bridged the ancient world with the modern and connected the earthly with the celestial. The call of the ancients, now a gentle hum in the background, accompanied Adrian as he prepared to share the tale of Tutankhamun's hidden legacy with the world.